I'm mixing flat red with thinner according to the directions on the bottle. This is only the third or fourth model I've painted with an airbrush, so I'm only comfortable doing base coats. All of the body parts of the tank will be red. I'm trying to only paint the tank body, but as you can see, I missed and I accidentally hit one of the bags. It takes a couple of coats to get an even spray. And I'll admit I may be rushing it. I think the red looks good overall. Gunmetal gray gives a nice metallic feel to the wheels and treads. After gunmetal, a coat of gray enhances the metal surfaces. This is Vallejo gray black, I believe. And it was mixed in with the rest of the gunmetal on the palette. In this video, my second so far, I still haven't learned where to place the camera for good focus. I've seen some very nice videos from other hobbyists, and I wonder what their secret is. Looking for places that I may have missed. And I seem to have found some on the underside of the treads. I've lightened the gray a little, and I'm trying to highlight areas with a bit of dry brushing. After touching up the wheels, I fill in the bumpers and tusks. I used light brown for the bags and hat. I'm trying to keep it very light and thin. I don't want the brown pigment filling in shadows and recesses. I would prefer if the black primer was to bleed through where there are shadows. Thank you. I use dark blue for the troll's skin. This is a good base. It fills everything in fairly completely. And I'll follow up with a little dab of game color, electric blue, mixed in. There's the game color. It's a much thicker paint. I actually have to unclog the nozzle before it'll come out. I use the back of a brush to blend. In my next video, I'll put some tape down so that I'll know where to hold the model. There's highlights on the knuckles of the troll, on the top of his arm, and I'm trying to leave the dark blue alone so it can serve as a shade. Mahogany brown will be used for the wooden cask. I'll mix in light brown for the highlights, and I'll use white on the label. You might notice that the tops of my bottles all have a little dab of paint on them, so that I can see what their true color is. This helps when picking out the right color for your job or your palette. And there we have a painted tank. I will try to find time to apply weathering next week. There are a few things I'm excited about. First, I like how the Vallejo primer didn't dissolve any of the foam. Not like my rattle can would have. It has a nice texture to it. And I think this model is ready for weathering. Thank you for watching.